Now, we'll say multiplicative inverse of the complex number. Let alpha is a comma b belongs to complex number, and we know that in complex numbers, multiplicative identity is 1 comma 0. Now, take one complex number beta, a by a square plus b square minus b by a square plus b square. If this beta satisfying, alpha beta equal to beta alpha equal to n, then we can say that beta is called the multiplicative inverse of complex number. We will see what is the value of alpha beta. What is here alpha we have? A comma b. And what is the value of beta we have? A by a square plus b square minus b by a square plus b square. Clearly this is in product, and we know that if the two complex numbers, if it is in product like this, what is that value we have? AC minus BD comma AD plus BC. Applying this property, ABC, AC, A into A by A square plus B square minus BD, B into D, B by A square plus B square comma, next AD, A into D value plus BC, B into C value. We'll simplify this. It is that A into A, A square by A square plus B square plus B square by A square plus B square, and in this one minus AB by A square plus B square plus AB by A square plus B square, right? Now here, what is that LCM? A square plus B square. So A square plus B square by A square plus B square, and in this one minus AB plus AB by A square plus B square. Clearly, minus AB plus AB cancel, and this A square plus B square, A square plus B square also cancel. We will get it. What is the value? 1 comma 0, which is nothing but what? N. So alpha into beta, we got it, N. Similarly, we can prove that beta into alpha equal to N, right? So here, beta is called the multiplicative inverse of alpha.